This is the Horse Radio Network. This is episode 152 of Horse Tip Daily, a different horse tip, a different equine topic, a different equestrian expert every day. Horse Tip Daily brings the world of equine knowledge to you one day at a time. Enjoy today's tip. Hi, this is Glenn the Geek back with you from Lexington, Kentucky here at Horse Tip Daily. Well, we have some great shows, as you know, on the Horse Radio Network, and one of those is the Dressage Radio Show. And Chris had the pleasure of talking to the number one dressage person in the world for the last 10, 15 years, and that's Anki von Grunsven. Anki was on the show this week's episode, so stop over to dressageradio.com and take a listen. I think you'll enjoy that. Well, today we have Betsy Cohen back with us. She knows more about leather care than anyone I know. She works for Bickmore, which is one of the leading companies in the leather care business. And Betsy has been working with them for over 10 years and is just a delightful lady. And you can listen to Betsy's previous tips on leather care just by going to horsetipdaily.com and searching under the experts tab for Betsy Cohen. Well, let's get to Betsy. Well, hi, Betsy, and welcome back to Horse Tip Daily.
Hey, thanks so much.
It's always good to have you on. I learn so much when you're on the show with me because I learn everything I've been doing wrong for the last 40 years.
Yeah, scary, isn't it? But, you know, technology is changing every day, so there's always something new for us to learn.
That's why people have to listen to this show every day, because you just get a well-rounded base of knowledge about everything horse.
And then they need to go and re-listen to anything that they might have forgotten over the time.
Yeah, well, that's great. Can I hire you?
Absolutely.
All right, here we go. We're talking about, you're obviously our leather care and horse care and grooming care expert. So what are we talking about today?
Storage.
Storage.
And what to do with the tech that you don't need right now.
Ah, you just throw it in the trunk and you walk away and you don't look at it for 2 years, right?
That's exactly what we're fighting about. You know, I'm the crazy leather lady at the barn, and basically, you know, the care of your leather is important, which we've already talked about, but the storage, you can take great care of it, and then if you store it wrong, you've got a whole other set of problems on your hands. So basically, whether it's a jacket for, you know, a nice leather jacket, or a bridle for next show season, or hey, you just sold that narrow withered horse and now you've got the picnic table shouldered, you know, moose of a horse, you know, and you need to put that saddle away, there are some pretty important keys to proper storage.
Okay.
And basically, the number one thing
is... Put it in the basement in the moldiest section?
Absolutely. Dark, scary, dank. that's the first place. Not. Actually, make sure all of the items that you're ready to store are in good repair, clean, and conditioned.
Which would have been the previous tips we did.
Right. Okay. But what I see is more often than not is something's broken, so you're putting that girth away, you know, into your tack trunk, and basically all of a sudden now you need it and you're pulling it out, and it not only is it dirty, crusty, salty from all the sweat, but oh, the billets are shot too and you need it now. So basically, rule of thumb is make sure when you go to put something away that it is repaired, cleaned, and conditioned. Okay.
Okay.
Second one is don't store anything leather in anything that will prohibit the leather from breathing. So you take your leather jacket to the dry cleaner and they clean it and they send it back to you in a plastic bag. Take it out of the plastic bag. You can, you know, cut a hole in a pillowcase and put it over the hanger. That's going to keep the dust and dirt out and basically still allow that leather to breathe. So do away with the dry cleaning plastic bags, the plastic garment bags, the fabric lined with plastic. If it's a waterproof or water repellent bag, you don't want that. Plastic tubs, shopping bags, these are all bad things that don't allow leather to breathe. And so when the air just lays there, it just allows little mold spores to just
So basically it's going to get, it's going to get moldier if you do that.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. Tight places with no ventilation and no air movement are bad, bad things. Location, where you store the tack is very important as well. It needs to be well ventilated, which we just talked about. You need it in a place where sun is going to get a chance to expose the leather, or a place where the light is on more often than not. So a closet doesn't really work, because yes, you have the closet light on for the 2 or 3 minutes that you're in there, or even maybe half an hour, but you're not leaving it on all the time. So the majority of the time, the leather needs to be exposed to light. Mold, spores, mildew love dark, dank, dingy, spooky places. Musty air.
So don't put it in your basement.
Absolutely not. So basically, wherever you don't want to be, that's where mold and mildew wants to be. So dark, dingy, scary stuff, it doesn't want to be there. So again, someplace where there's a light, or a light on it, or, you know, sun can get to it. Dry air is also very important. So I love walking into a tack room that has a dehumidifier going. That's a great place, because it's sucking all that wet air out of there, and all of a sudden the mold has nothing to do. It can't hang out with its buddies and procreate and all that, because, you know, it doesn't have what it needs
right
to be happy. So, well-ventilated, sun-filled or light-filled, and dry. Those three things will prevent mold from taking over your tack. Right. Or your jackets and clothing, or your footwear. Everything. Anything that's leather.
Well, I learned something. I knew you weren't supposed to put it in the dark, dank, moldy spot. But I actually never thought about the whole plastic bag thing.
Or the tack trunks. I mean, yes, okay, wood tack trunks breathe, but again, that air... And wood can breathe a little bit, you know, through the cracks and crevices, but it's not a good place for tack to be kept. So it really needs to be out and about. So, and, you know, I don't want sun beating down on it, because then you're going to have color fading and all of that. But, you know, someplace where I would love to see a tack room with the sunshine streaming in, and a dehumidifier in the corner, and a washer and dryer there for everyone to use, and anal retentive leather care people at that barn. That would be my little horse-topia.
Well, of course, with the dryer vented to the outside.
Exactly, yes.
All right, Betsy. Yeah. People can find out more about the company you work for. That's Bickmore, which is Bickmore, BICKMORE.com. And you have a complete line of leather care products there, as well as horse care, health care, grooming care, all kinds of products. Just stop by there, check it out, and your dealer locator's right on there, so they can find a dealer to buy your products.
Excellent. Or they could ask their local retailer to start carrying our product.
Well, thank you to Betsy, and we appreciate her being on. You know, she helps us take care of those leather products we pay so much for, and we might as well take care of them after we get them. Well, we're going to be back again on Monday. It's the weekend. You all have a great weekend. Don't forget to listen to the other shows at horseradionetwork.com. And we'll be back with another new expert and another horse tip on Monday. Have a good one, and stay safe, everyone.